have it, folks.
No more sunshine. It's followed you away. I'll cry, birdie, till you're home to stay.
Thank you very much.
I'll miss the way you smile, as though it's just for me. And each and every night, I'll write to you faithfully.
That's enough.
Bye, bye, birdie. It's awful hard to bear. Bye, bye, birdie. Guess I'll always care.
I'll miss him terribly. It's gonna be real hard.
But to ease the pain, we got a lot of birdie stuff.
Like my birdie sweats. I wear them day and night.
Really,
I drink birdie cola.
And I eat my birdie flakes every morning.
Me too.
My collection of birdie statues are priceless.
And on my calendar, I mark the fateful day that will report to Uncle Sam and fight for
me. Bye, bye, bye.
Savage beast, the army should make you
a general at least. Bye, bye, birdie. Do what you have to do. Come back, birdie. I will wait for you. We'll be here for you.
I know that, sir, but think of the disastrous effects this might have on the morale of the American teenager. No, I'm not saying that the boy doesn't want to go in the army. It's just that what I'm trying to say is that, well, it seemed to me that 2 weeks from today, at the induction center, he'll be there. Rosie, thank God you've come. This is the end of Almelu Music Corporation. Conrad Birdie is going into the army.
And your faithful secretary is hereby submitting her resignation.
Huh?
I just dropped in to say goodbye, Albert, darling. Lots of luck.
Rosie, you can't. Not today of all days. My pills. Where are my pills? You know the little white ones I take when I'm overwrought?
Here.
Not so much. Can you break it in half?
Albert, you're 33 years old. You can take a whole aspirin.
I am not 33. I'm a long way from 33. I won't be 33 till tomorrow. Water.
It's no use, Albert. My mind is made up. I've been with Almelu for 8 years now, and as you well know, I've been a lot more than just a secretary to you.
Rose, those were moments of madness.
Well, between the moments of madness and the office hour, I've put in a good 90-hour week. And for what? A $5 pay raise in 1954 and a bottle of Angelique last Christmas?
Rosie, promise her anything but give her Angelique.
Yeah, but not a 16th of an ounce. Besides, I want something more than that.
Rosie, if you're referring to anything of a more permanent nature between you and me, I'm not ready for it. Besides, there are religious differences.
Spanish is not a religion.
And if it's part of the company you're after, it's no to that, too. Alma Lou is me, Mama, and Lou. And any changes in that would kill that wonderful woman who bore me.
Nothing could kill your mother, Albert, except maybe a silver bullet.
And I won't drop poor old Lou either. He loved you, Rose.
I loved Lou, too. Sure, he was warm, and he was lovable, and he was loyal, but he died 6 years ago. And besides, he was a wire-haired terrier. Anyhow, I don't want any part of the business. This is something much more important to me.
Rosie, if you're going to discuss what I think you're going to discuss, I'm in no mood to discuss it.
There's nothing to discuss, Albert. Conrad Birdie is going into the army, and I've quit. There's nothing left for you to do but give up the business and go back to college to get
Rosie, I'm up to my ears in debt. Conrad's got a $50,000 guarantee that I can't pay, and I've just taken a severe overdose of aspirin.
Albert, this may be your last chance. Will you listen to me, Albert? I'm serious. His going in the army is the best thing he could do. Now you're free to start to do what you wanted to. Albert, Albert, Albert. I remember how you told me I should trust you for a year. It would just be for a year, but it's 8 years, Albert. 8 long years, Albert.
Rosie, it takes time to build a business.
It was only a sideline, that's what you said. You just needed some money, that's what you said. You were going to college and get ahead. Instead of being a music business bum, you were going to NYU and become...
Don't say it, Rosie.
...an English teacher. And furthermore, he wrote poetry. And in the NYU yearbook of 1952, under Albert Peterson's favorite piece of literature, you want to know what it says?
Rosie, please.
Little Women.
I'm ruined in show business.
An English teacher, an English teacher. If only you'd been an English teacher, we'd have a little apartment in Queens. You'd get a summer vacation, and we could know what life means. A man who's got his master's is really someone. How proud I'd be if you had become one. It could have been such a wonderful life. I could have been Mrs. Peterson, Mrs. Albert Peterson, Mrs. Phi Beta Kappa Peterson, the English teacher's wife. Was goodbye, Geoffrey Chaucer. Hello, William Morris. Goodbye, NYU. Hello, Alma Lou, 'cause when you wrote Conrad's first hit, Ugga Bugga Boo, then I knew that was it. You were through with English forever. An English teacher is really someone. How proud I'd be if you had become one. It could have been such a wonderful life. I could have been Mrs. Peterson, Mrs. Albert Peterson, Mrs. Phi Beta Kappa Peterson, the English teacher's wife.
Rose, I'll make a deal with you. Stay here. Help me get the money to pay Conrad's guarantee, And I promise, as soon as I'm out of the red, I'll dissolve the company and go back to the academic life.
Albert, you're on.
Of course, it may take a while, but I'm sure that by 1973 or 74 at the latest, we'll be able to...
Here.
What's that?
Something that's going to push that date up a few years. Pick a name.
Pick what name? What are you talking about?
Fine, I'll pick one for you. McAfee. Kim McAfee. Age 15, president and recording secretary of the Conrad Birdie Fan Club. Number 2748 of Sweet Apple, Ohio. Mary, yes, can you get me to Sweet Apple, Ohio, please? Yes, the number is 2748-3320. And call me right back.
Wait a minute. What's going on here? Who's Kim, whatever her name is?
Kim McAfee, Albert, is what's going to send you back to college with the biggest hit single this business has ever seen. It's called One Last Kiss.
I've never heard of it.
That's because you haven't written it yet. But when you do, and when that one last kiss is given from Conrad Birdie on his way to the Big Cold Army for 2 long years, and when that one last kiss is given to one of his fans, chosen at random from 1,200,000 hysterical teenagers, it'll make Conrad Birdie the hottest soldier since Joan of Arc.
Rose, I'm beginning to see it. We cut the record here in New York.
Take that greasy bongo-playing car thief to Sweet Apple.
Let him kiss the kid.
And release the record. Albert, you'll have enough money to stay in college the rest of your life.
Oh, Rosie, it's wonderful. And I promise, as soon as all of this is settled, it'll be just you and me, Rose. I'll get a job teaching English and... Bliss. That rhymes with kiss. I wonder if anyone's ever used it before. Oh, what does it matter? It'll be great for the song. Oh, one last kiss, it gives so much bliss. What is your... Dentifrice! No, that's too clinical.
An English teacher, an English teacher. Someday he may be an English teacher. Hello? Well, what do you mean every phone in Sweet Apple is busy? What's going on there? Kim McAfee just got pinned to who? Oh, never mind, Mary. Keep trying and call me right back. Then we'd have such a wonderful life. Then I might be Mrs. Peterson, Mrs. Albert Peterson, Mrs. Phi Beta Kappa Peterson, the English teacher's
about Hugo and Kim.
Hi, Margie.
Hi, Alice. What's the story, Morning Glory?
What's the word, Hummingbird? Is it true about Hugo and Kim?
Did they really get pinned?
Did she kiss him and cry? Did he pin a pin on? Or was he too shy? Well, I heard they got pinned.
Yeah, yeah. He's gone. Hello, Mr. Hinkle. This is Harvey Johnson. And I speak Penelope and... Penelope?
I
got the prom.
I can't talk to you now.
You know it, man. It's crazy, man. You know it.
It won't last. Not at all. He's too thin. She's too tall.
Hello, Mr. Miller. This is Harvey Johnson.
Can I speak to Debra Sue?
Hiya, Hugo. Hiya, stupid. What you wanna go get pinned for? Hiya, meathead. Washed your marbles. Are you nutty?
Hello.
She saw him, she dug him, she nailed him. If you gotta go, that's the way to go. When they got you hooked, then you're really cooked. What you gonna do? What you gonna do?
Well, I heard they got
me. Oh, man.
I told them they would.
Oh, man. Oh, man.
Going steady, going steady.
Going steady for good.
Together to worship that wonderful creature. Do you realize what you'd be giving up, Kim?
I'm sorry, Ursula, but my mind's made up. Of course, I'll still play his records, but things like the pledge and the Conrad Birdie scream are past me now.
You're giving up the scream? You mean when Conrad Birdie sings on television, you're not going to go,
all right, Mother. Sorry, Ursula, I've got to hang up. You'll explain everything to the other kids, won't you?
I suppose I'll have to. Bye, Kim. Kim, are you sure? I mean, after all. I mean, really, Kim, are you absolutely sure?
Positive. After all, I'm 15 years old, and it's time I settled down. When you're a skinny child of 14, wired with braces from ear to ear, you doubt that you could ever be appealing. Then, hallelujah, you are 15 and the braces disappear, and your skin is smooth and clear, and you have that happy grown-up female feeling. How lovely to be a woman. The wait was well worthwhile. How lovely to wear mascara and smile a woman's smile. How lovely to have a figure that's round instead of flat. Whenever you hear a boy's whistle, what they're whistling at. It's wonderful to feel the way a woman feels. It gives you such a glow just to know you're wearing lipstick and heels. How lovely to be a woman and have one job to do. To pick out a boy and train him. And then when you are through, you've made him the man you want him to be. Life's lovely when you're a woman like me. How wonderful to know the things a woman knows. How marvelous to wait for a date in simply beautiful clothes. How lovely to be a woman and change from boys to men. To go to a fancy nightclub and stay out after 10. How lovely to be so grown up and free. Life's lovely when you're a woman like me. Thank you, Doris. I'll take it down there.
She's kind of a long distance, and I can't imagine. What did you just say?
I said thank you, Doris. Oh, there's no need to look so upset. It's modern now to call your mother by her first name. Makes mother and daughter more like pals.
And your father?
I'll call him Harry, naturally. By the way, I think that Harry took the news about Hugo and I awfully well. Don't you, Doris? This is she. Yes, I'll wait.
I don't know. Yesterday, I was a mother. Today, I'm a pal. Are you sure you would like to call me Mom? That's modern.
I'm sorry, but times are changing, and you've got to go along with them, or else be left behind with the old folks. By the way, Doris, have you got a cigarette? I seem to have run out.
I'm not an old man. I was 18 in World War II.
Conrad Birdie? Is coming here to kiss me.
Why is it so like breezy?
Doris. Doris. Mother. Mommy. Mommy. Mommy.
What is it? What's wrong?
It's Conrad Birdie. Mommy, he's going to kiss me.
That's nice, dear. Now you just put your head on Mommy's shoulder.
Oh, no, you don't understand. Conrad Birdie is coming here to Sweet Apple to kiss me goodbye. Oh, Mommy, Mommy.
I never thought I'd say it, but God bless Conrad Birdie.
We love you, Conrad. Oh, yes, we do. We love you, Conrad, and we'll be true. When you're not near us, we're blue. Oh, Conrad, we love you.
Hi, girls. Sorry I'm late. Now, let's go over the Birdie song once more before we go down to the train.
We love you, Conrad. Oh, yes, we do. We love you.
little girls. You could sing with us if you'd like. What's the matter with them?
Oh, they're just sad because Conrad's going into the army and they'll be told for him when he gets out.
Well, I think they still have a few good years left. How about you girls go down to track 12 and I'll talk to them. Hi, little girls. I'm Albert Peterson, Conrad's manager. Oh, come on, things can't be that bad. Smile. Little girl, this is an adult speaking, and I order you to smile. Please? Gray skies are gonna clear up. Put on a happy face. Brush off the clouds and cheer up. Put on a happy face. Take off that gloomy mask of tragedy. It's not your style. You'll look so good that you'll be glad you decided to smile. Pick out a pleasant outlook. Stick out that noble chin. Wipe off that full of doubt look. Slap on a happy grin. And spread sunshine all over the place. Just put on a happy face. Put on a happy face. Put on a happy face. And if you're feeling cross and bickerish, don't sit and whine. Think of banana splits and licorice and you'll feel fine. I knew a girl so gloomy, she'd never laugh or sing. She wouldn't listen to me, now she's a mean old thing. So spread sunshine all over the place, just put on a happy face. My gosh, there's our luggage. Little girl, you better get down to track 12 if you want to see Conrad before he goes. Oh boy, could you get our luggage down to track 12 on the double? Rosie, what are you doing?
Getting our things down to the station without any help from you, Albert.
Oh, Rosie, I'm sorry. I don't suppose a generous tip could make things up.
Albert, just take your briefcase and go down to the train before any of those reporters talk to Conrad alone. You remembered what happened last time.
You hang on to it, Rosie. I've got to wait for Mama.
Speaking of your mother, Albert, have you talked to her about dissolving Alma Lou?
I couldn't, Rose. Yesterday was the anniversary.
Of what?
Lou. 6 years ago, he was hit on 181st Street and Broadway by a loaded beer truck. Do you suppose that's Mama?
It's either her or the all clear.
Yo-ho! Sunny boy.
Mama.
Ooh.
Mama, what's the matter?
Nothing's the matter. I'm just a little faint from the subway.
Mama, I told you to take a taxi.
Taxi? What do I need with taxis? I'll leave the taxis to my successful son. A mother can ride crowded on a dirty subway with people who wouldn't give you a seat if your life depended on it. But what's the difference? I'm only a mother. Here's the money I saved from not taking the taxi. Buy yourself some candy with it. Who's she?
Mama, you know Rose Alvarez from the office.
This is Rose Alvarez. Pretty little Rose Alvarez. Rose, what happened? You have a sudden shock or something.
Excuse me, Albert. I think I'll go see if Conrad is here.
By all means, Miss Alvarez. Look at her, Sonny. How nice she looks. It's a wonder to me some older gentleman doesn't snatch her off. A personal matron with brains and a few dollars. What a catch you'd be for a convalescent. Goodbye, Rose.
Goodbye, May.
Call me Mrs. Peterson.
Now, Mama, what I wanted to talk to you about is sort of about Rose. Maybe you'd better sit down.
Why? I know my sonny boy. He loves his mama. He wouldn't say anything that would break her heart. Go ahead, dear. What about Rose?
Well, it's about Lou, too.
Lou? Where are you, Lou? Struck down by a beverage I so faithfully consumed for 32 years. What about Lou?
Well, Mama, it's just that Rosie thinks... I've decided to give up Alma Lou.
Oh.
Mama, what's the matter?
Well, nothing's the matter. You've just killed me is all. I'm on my way up, Lou. I'm coming up.
You don't understand, Mama. It's just that Rosie thought... Look, Mama, here's some money. Take a taxi home. The subways are too crowded.
Nothing is too crowded for a mother. I'll go during rush hour. That's the worst time. Oh, how many blocks is it? Only 107, sweetheart. I'll just walk.
Mama.
Enjoy yourself, son. Take care. Be careful crossing the street. Keep your money on your inside pocket. Wear a heavy coat. Wear your galoshes. Eat a hot lunch.
Albert, I thought you were going to break it to her gently.
Well, as a matter of fact, Rosie, I didn't break it to her at all. I mean, she was so upset about my leaving that I thought I'd better wait.
You mean you didn't?
He's coming! He's coming! Conrad Birdie's coming!
Come on, Rosie, Conrad's coming, and we can't let him talk to those reporters alone.
But Albert, you promised me.
Later, Rosie, Conrad needs me.
How about a couple of questions, Conrad? Like, how do you feel about going to the army?
How does he feel? You ask how he feels? He's much too shy to tell you, so I'll tell you how he feels. He feels brave and eager, strangely humble, proud to be a plain GI.
He would gladly face those bullets, for he's not afraid to die.
And that's why he volunteered.
Volunteered? I thought he was drafted.
And he appealed 3 times.
Sing.
We love you, Conrad. Oh, yes, we do. We love you, Conrad. And we'll be true. When you're not near us, we're blue. Oh, Conrad, we love you.
What's the deal with the Hollywood Scarlet, Conrad? Are you two engaged?
Is he engaged? Is Conrad engaged? There's absolutely nothing to the rumor he's engaged.
She's a real pal, like a sister, but it doesn't mean a thing. And that 18-carat diamond, it was just a friendship ring.
Then why was her husband so mad?
Sing.
Yes, we do. We love you, Conrad, and we'll be true.
I'll never forget Conrad's first words when he had heard he'd been accepted into the armed forces. "Gee, Mr. Peterson," he said eagerly, "do you suppose they'll assign me to the frontline trenches? That way I can get myself one of those dirty Jerrys,
Albert,
or whoever's dirty this time."
"Mr. Peterson, give us the real scoop. Is Conrad still drinking a lot?"
"Now listen here. That gossip must stop. He goes to church each Sunday and he doesn't touch a drop.
He's as decent as a minister.
Absolutely.
He's as sober as a judge. He subscribes to every charity. And his hobby's making fudge.
He's a kind of
Is it true that you found Conrad in a reform school?"
That is a lie. A lie through and through. I'll tell you where he came from. Here's the story, and it's true.
He was born in Indochina.
He was born in Old Virginia.
Son of missionaries there.
On a 1,000-acre farm.
Very poor and very hungry.
From a line of wealthy planters.
Full of life to bear.
Full of genteel southern charm.
Soon he drifted down to Hong Kong.
Every evening by the river.
To a waterfront saloon.
By the moonlight they would croon.
That is where I heard him sing.
That's where Conrad started singing.
Neath the shining moon.
Neath the old plantation moon.
Oh, beautiful for spacious skies, for amber waves of grace. America, America, God shed his grace on thee, for he's a fine, upstanding, average, modest, patriotic, healthy, normal, American, American born.
Conrad's speech for him. You get the bags, stack them, and bring them to the house. If I see a taxi, I'll send it back. For he's a fun.
Yeah, we should go.
Kim, before you go, I have a question.
Right now? I mean, couldn't it wait? I'm in an awful hurry.
I don't think so. It's important.
Hugo Peabody, what's so important that you have to talk to her right now?
What's so important? I'll tell you what's so important. The day after I give Kim my pin, you guys aren't kissing somebody else. That's what's so important. I have you know, I'm quite upset about this. I've already had several headaches and a nosebleed.
Hugo, I believe you're jealous of Conrad, Birdie.
Me? Jealous? I'm the opposite of jealous. I'm very jealous.
But I have every right to be. Kim's my steady.
Oh, that's just it. I'm your steady. Oh, I may admire Conrad Birdie as one admires a far distant and unattainable ideal, but I'm into you, Hugo, and I don't care how common and ordinary you are. That's how I'm going to stay.
You're not just saying that to make me feel better.
I mean every word of it, Hugo. Conrad Birdie's a fling. A steady is forever.
I didn't even realize till I sat down.
One boy, one steady boy. One boy to love with, to talk with and talk with. One boy, that's the way it should be. That's the way it should be. Boy, one certain boy, one boy to laugh with, to joke with, have coke with. One boy, not two or three. One day you'll find out this is what life is all about. You need someone who is living just for you. One boy, one steady boy, one boy to be with forever.
I feel so much better. All thoughts of a nosebleed have utterly vanished.
You are silly to worry, Hugo. Conrad Birdie may be a great public figure, but he doesn't make me feel all dizzy and faint when I think of him. Why, even when I say his name, I don't feel a thing. Listen. Conrad Birdie. Conrad Birdie. Conrad Birdie.
One boy, one steady boy. One boy to be with forever and ever. One boy, that's the way it should be. That's the way it should be. That's the way it should be.
The boy she loves is the boy who almost makes her faint and dizzy. And you hear that, lady? That boy's me!
One day you'll find out this is what life is all about. You
one special guy, one guy to live for, to care for, be there for.
Rosie, what's the matter?
Nothing, Albert. I was just thinking of you.
Never mind thinking of me. My speech, where is it?
It's in the briefcase.
Good, bring it along. The mayor's almost finished talking. Come on.
That's the way it should be.
Well, shut up.
And so it is with great pride and prejudice, as well as the usual pomp and circumstance, that I welcome you to our fair city and present you with the 14-carat solid gold key so generously donated by men from the Sweet Apple Brass Works. And as I present this key to you, Conrad Birdie...
He said it! He said the name!
What happened? All I said was Conrad Birdie. If you girls don't stop, then I can't finish my speech.
Who cares about your speech? We want to hear from Conrad! Speak to us, oh beautiful one. Tell us how you make that glorious sound that even now, in anticipation of it, has reduced me to a snarling, raging, panting jungle beast.
You gotta be sincere.
Edna, what's the matter?
You gotta be sincere.
Mr. Birdie, what are you doing?
You gotta feel it here. Cause if you feel it here, well then you're gonna be honestly sincere.
Edna!
If what you feel is true, really feel it too. Make them feel it too. Write this down now, you gotta be sincere, honestly sincere. Man, you gotta be sincere. If you're really sincere, if you're really sincere, if you feel it in here, man, it's gotta be right. Oh, baby. Oh, honey. Hug me. Suffer. In everything I do, my sincerity shows through. I look you in the eye, don't really have to try. It's automatic, I'm sincere. When I sing about a tree, I really feel that tree. When I sing about a girl, I really feel that girl. I mean, I really feel sincere. If you're really sincere, if you're really sincere, if you feel it in here, man, it's gotta be right, oh baby. Oh honey, hug me, suffer. You gotta be sincere. Oh, 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 you gotta feel it in here. Oh, my baby. Oh, my baby. Oh, yeah. Oh, my baby. Oh, yeah. Were you gonna be sincere? 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 Oh, my baby, oh yeah. Oh, my baby, oh yeah. Were you gonna be sincere? Were you gonna be sincere? Oh, my baby, oh yeah. Oh, my baby, oh yeah. Oh, my baby, oh yeah. Oh, my baby, oh, oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Thank you.
We promised to sing the birdie song 10,000 times, didn't we? Well, we have 5,276 to go. So sing.
We love you, Conrad. Oh, yes, we do. We love you, Conrad, and we'll be true.
Daddy, I wish you'd hurry. I want to have all this mess cleared away before Conrad comes down.
This mess, as you call it, Kim, happens to be my breakfast, and I intend to enjoy it.
Your father has the right to enjoy his breakfast, dear.
Yeah.
But I'm sure he won't mind if we start clearing away some of these other things. I know the house is a bit hectic this morning. But Kim's gone to a lot of trouble to pick a special breakfast for Mr. Birdie, and I want to make sure everything is ready and waiting for him when he comes down. After all, he is a national figure, and I want to show these New York people we know how to treat a national figure here in Sweet Apple. Of course, it doesn't mean that much to me personally, but for Kim's sake, I... There we go. All done. Did you enjoy it, dear? Good. Now if you'll just hurry along.
Doris, I'm not budging from this room till I get my coffee, smoke a cigarette, and read my paper.
Oh, I'm sorry, dear. I didn't have time to make your coffee this morning. How about a nice warm 7-Up?
Morning, Pop. Here's your paper. Oh, I hope you don't mind, but I cut a few stories out about Conrad.
I have tried to run this house on a democratic basis. I have extended the privilege of self-determination to both the woman I have married and the children I have sired. The vote has been denied no one for reason of age, sex, or political affiliation. There has been no taxation without representation, and open covenants have been openly arrived at. Last night, I gave up my room to a guest who repeatedly referred to me as Fats. Telephone calls were made to New York, Chicago, Fairbanks, Alaska, and Hong Kong. I slept in a camp cot with my head in an ashtray and my feet in the fireplace. Outside my window, three harpies shrieked, "We love you, Conrad!" 4,723 times. And I have just lost two pieces of toast. Gentlemen, the democracy is over. Parliament has been dissolved. The Magna Carta has been revoked. And Nero is back in town. And you don't offer an emperor a warm 7-Up.
Oh, Mr. McAfee, I hope you won't mind keeping off the phone for a few minutes. We're expecting a long-distance call from New York.
Oh, perfectly all right. I'll go and burn Rome.
Mother, what's wrong?
Nothing, dear. Your father's just excited about Conrad being here, that's all.
He's coming! He's coming!
He's coming. I'll grab the food. Mother, you call the kids.
Girls, he's coming. You're gonna hurry
and watch him
eat.
Eric, him!
I'm sorry, Doris, but we just had to come, too. We'll stand quietly back here.
He's here.
Call me for lunch. What's up, Fats?
Now look here, Doris, about that boy.
He's just shy.
Well, if you ask me.
After all, Doris, Kim is only 15 and I...
Please, not in front of everybody.
Ursula, we'd better go.
I don't care who's here. No ill-mannered lout is going to...
Tell him, Pop!
Right, shut up.
Now, Harry, you have no right to say that. This boy is our guest, and...
This is my house, and until you're 18...
But, Pop!
I said shut up! Until you're 18...
But, Pop!
Will you leave me alone?
Mr. and Mrs. McAfee, Kim, Randolph, is this the way you want 75 million Americans to see you?
What are you talking about?
You're all going to be on television with Conrad.
On television?
Yes, that's right. I just got the confirmation from New York, from Ed Sullivan himself.
You mean we're going to be on The Sullivan Show? The Ed Sullivan Show?
Yes, that's right. They're going to cut in on Sweet Apple this Sunday night at 8:05, and you're all going to be on there with Conrad. So I beg you, put aside all petty differences, because to that great audience out there, you're an American dream come true. And for the free world's sake, Mr. McAfee, don't destroy that dream.
Me? On the Ed Sullivan Show? Ed Sullivan!
sudden, me, Harry McAfee, appearing with Ed Sullivan. Ed Sullivan. Ed Sullivan.
Ed Sullivan. Ed Sullivan. Ed. Ed. Sol. Sol. Ed Sullivan. Ed Sullivan. We're gonna be on Ed Sullivan.
How could any family be half as fortunate as we?
We'll be coast to coast with our favorite host, Ed Sullivan. Ed Sullivan, we're gonna be on Ed Sullivan.
I've got a wonderful life, two swell kids, a good job, and now this.
Someday we'll recall the greatest day of all.
Ed, I love you.
Albert, what do you think?
It looks great, Rosie. Now, there's something very important.
Of course, it was used as an old movie house for the past 30 years, but I think it should be okay.
It'll be swell, Rosie. Now, what I wanted to say was...
And they're shipping down the camera's lights today, and...
Rosie, I'm sure everything will be perfect. Now, if you'll just forget about the Sullivan Show for one moment, there's something very important I need to tell you about you and me, Rosie.
You and I, English teacher?
Rosie, I'm serious. What I wanted to say was that I'm very glad you and me are out here together. Being away from New York has made me see all kinds of things in a different light, which is why I wanted you to know that I decided to write Mama and tell her that no matter what, I'm giving up Alma Lou.
Oh, Albert, you didn't.
Rosie, I did. I wrote her the day we left, which leaves 3 days and 3 nights for her to get back to us. And so far, not a word. If you ask me, she's accepted the whole thing by now.
3 days and 3 nights on a trailways bus. But what's the difference? I'm only a mother, and for a mother, a trailways bus is good enough.
Mama, what are you doing here?
You think I wouldn't come? A mother gets a letter obviously written under the influence of drugs, and she should stay at home? Pay no attention. It's only a mother's tears. Dear Mom, this is to let you know that Almay Lou is dissolved. Your friend, Albert. Almay Lou is dissolved? Dissolve me! What am I, a sick old woman? Probably won't last the night. All I want is a simple stone with one word on it. Albert's mother. Never mind hiring a limousine to take me to the final resting place. No, I'll walk.
Mama!
And tell that Spanish friend of yours I forgive her. She knoweth not what she doneth.
Mama, Rosie is right there.
Oh. Rose Alvarez. She looks like Margot after they brought her out of Shangri-La. For her own sake, Albert, send her back to Tibet. Never mind finding a secretary. It just so happens I met on the bus a lovely, refined girl on her way to Akron, only I persuaded her to get off here. Sonny, meet Gloria Rasputin.
Hi, Al.
Hey,
You're cute.
But, Mama, I don't need a secretary. I have Rosie.
What does Rosie need a job for? In a few years, she'll be getting Social Security.
Well, listen, I don't just type.
You do other things?
I tap dance. I figured I could help you with the secretary stuff, and you could help me get into showbiz. Hold this, honey. May, can you hum me Swanee River?
It's my favorite selection.
Get a load of this, Al.
Bravo, sweetheart.
Well, do I get the job?
Well, you certainly do have wonderful qualifications, but I'm used to working with Miss Alvarez. However, as you say, Mama, we are faced with a certain amount of extra work. Do you have to stay down there?
Only a moment. May, grab my hand. Al, you get the other side. On three. One, two, three. Easy.
They can always cut away while they jack her up in the movie, sweetheart. Why don't you take Gloria and see how fast she types?
But I do have a lot of releases to get out, and Gloria could do them, unless it makes any difference to you, Rosie.
Why should it make any difference to me?
Atta girl, Rosie, you stay here and I'll go along with Miss Rasputin. Do you use the touch system?
Whenever possible.
I could kill him. I could just kill him.
Miss Alvarez, do you know where Kim McAfee is anywhere? Because I wanted to tell her that she's not to kiss Conrad Birdie on the Ed Sullivan show tonight. Because if she does, I'll... Miss Alvarez? Is everything all right? Miss Alvarez, it's me, Hugo Peabody. Miss Alvarez, can I do anything for you?
Yes, Hugo, I think you can.
So remember, your surest way to the best in color slides is to insist on the new Kodak. And now, the young man you've all been waiting to see. As you know, in just about 14 hours, one of show business's brightest talents is going off to play a very special engagement. And tonight, before he goes, he wants to leave a certain lucky young lady with one last kiss. Ladies and gentlemen, we take you to Sweet Apple, Ohio, where a typical American family, Mr. and Mrs. McAfee and their children, Randolph and Kim, are gathered to bid farewell to a typical American soldier, Conrad Birdie.
Where's Ed?
Oh, one last kiss, oh, give me one last kiss. It never felt like this, no, never felt like this. You know I need your love, oh, 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 oh. Give me one last kiss. Oh, one more time, oh, baby, one more time. It really is sublime, oh, honey, so sublime. You know I need your love, oh, 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 oh. Give me one last kiss. Baby, give me one last kiss. Baby, give me one last kiss. Oh, one last kiss.
last kiss. Oh, give me one last kiss. It never felt like this. No, never felt like this. You know I need your love. Oh, give me one last kiss. One last kiss, oh, give me one last kiss. It never felt like this, no, never felt like this. You know I need your love. Oh, give me one last kiss. Oh, one more time, oh, baby, one more time. It really is sublime, oh, honey, so sublime. You know I need your love. Oh, give me one last kiss. Give me one last kiss. Give me one last kiss.
Brace yourself, Chief.
Brace yourself, Conrad Birdie.
Hugo, you hit him. Hugo F. Peabody, I never want to speak to you again.
What is going on in here? I demand to know who let that boy in here.
I did, Albert.
Rosie.
It's sort of my farewell gift to you and Miss Rasputin. We're in good health.
Rosie, you can't leave me here alone.
Oh, you're not alone, Albert. You're on television.
For he's a fine, upstanding, patriotic, healthy, normal American boy. For he's a fine, upstanding, patriotic, healthy, normal American boy.